Assalamualaikum and hi to everyone. Welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we just give a discussion about the statistical TDM. Previous video, we already discussed about the synchronous TDM. So another TDM that can be categorized is statistical TDM. In synchronous TDM, if there is no signal being transmitted from the devices, we still allocate the empty slot before we send the data. So each channel still have their own slot when we combine to be in a frame. In statistical TDM, slots are dynamically allocated in order to improve the bandwidth efficiency. We don't want to send empty slot, so we introduce another technique that we call a dynamic slot for statistical TDM. So the number of slot in each frame is less than the number of the input line. Okay, let's say we have number of input line is 4, but the input line number 3 doesn't send any signal. So the number slot of each frame will be 3, because we don't bother with the device number 3. Okay. You can look at this example. We have line A until line E, so total we have 5 line. In synchronous TDM, 5 line A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, at this point, only A, B, and D send the signal. However, we still allocate the empty slot for C and for E. In statistical TDM, we have 5 lines A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, only A, B, and D send the signal. So when we create a frame, when we want to create a frame, we only cater A, B, and D. For example, A, B, and D. So only here we have A, B, and D. So the total slot in each frame are lesser compared to the number of the channels. Depends on the signal that being transmitted based on the devices. That are the difference between the synchronous TDM and the statistical TDM. Okay, the slot size, the ratio of the data size to the address size must be reasonable in order to make transmission is more efficient. Okay, usually block of data in many bytes while the address is just a few bytes. Okay, without synchronization bits and the bandwidth, the capacity of the link is normally less than the sum of the capacity of each channel. And the capacity of the link based of the statistics of the load for each channel during the peak time, slot time, and need to wait. This part is when we use the statistical time division. And we apply this statistical time division at the telephone line in digital signal, T line and E line based on the European digital TV broadcasting, current signal for our TV by digital preview, and the data transmitting via the LAN or WAN network. We use the statistical TDM. So, overall in multiplexing channel, in multiplexing topic, okay, we have discussed about the concept of multiplexing, the techniques under the multiplexing. We have 4, okay, categorized into 3, FDM, WDM, and TDM. TDM is divided into 2. We have synchronous and we have statistical TDM. So that's all for the multiplexing topic. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.